Thanks for tuning in to Happy Science New York podcast with Yushi and Mariko. Hi, everyone. Welcome to our very first video podcast from Happy Science New York. I am here with...
I'm the Minister of Happy Science New York Temple, Yushi.
And I am Vice Minister Mariko. And we're going to start this series to kind of answer some of your questions and just give you a little bit more about who we are, what we do, and why. So today's first episode is going to be about what is happy science. So let's try to answer that question. So maybe you can start. What is happy science?
What is happy science? Don't we always have a hard time answering this question?
Yeah.
Because happy science is like a... If I use the terms of a company, it's like a huge conglomerate, right? Mm-hmm. I mean, if you go to our website, you see that we're a religion, we have a political party, we have two high school, junior, senior high schools, Happy Science University, and a lot of charity work, and we have the media, we have it's like, what is this thing?
Right.
So it's very hard to answer this, but the most important basic part of Happy Science, obviously, it is a religious organization. And it's an all-encompassing religion because as Master Okawa, the founder of Happy Science, has taught us that all religions and all saviors come from the same source. And what's so wonderful about Happy Science is that we believe in that source. His name is El Cantare, and El Cantare is now descended on Earth as like the grand savior, Master Riho Okawa. So Happy Science is an all-encompassing faith to begin with. And also, it's a very educational institute. I mean, we used to be called the Institute of Research in Human Happiness.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And the reason why is because Master Okawa wanted to imply the importance of knowledge of God's truth or Buddha's truth. So it's so wonderful that it's an educational institution about spirituality, not only spirituality, about happiness in general. And we can believe in the source or the God of the earth. So I guess that's my answer to what's happy science. What's your take?
Well, when I think about the mission of happy science and why Master Okawa started happy science, of course you can read more about the beginnings and everything like that through the Laws of the Sun, the book, the Laws of the Sun, which is our most important book. And but thinking about the mission, I think is basically to make people happy, number one, and show us how, number two, and also spread that to other people. So we're living in a time that it's required to have a spiritual backbone.
Definitely.
Right?
Yes.
We see, you know, so many people breaking down these days. It's a global society. Everything is instant. So there's a lot of different, you know, things that are going on. And I don't think that people can survive anymore without the spiritual backbone. So I think it's really of the times to have such a teaching. And also, I think that happy science is like an immune system for the planet. So it makes people happier, but it also negate or takes away negativity.
Yes.
So everyone is taught how to become more spiritually strong and also understand the mind and how to become happy and independently happy, mentally independent. So we don't depend on things and become kind of weak in a sense. So this spiritual backbone is what I think is one of the greatest points of happy science. And its mission is to really strengthen people and make people happy. So that's my take.
And piggybacking from what you just said, that spirituality is like a very important backbone for our lives. That's so true. But what I noticed about the word spirituality is that it's very subjective because the spiritual world is not completely the world of science, where 1 + 1 is always 2. It shows differently depending on the spiritual leader or the awakened person, right? So there's a lot of spiritual books out there, but what I believe that happy science makes a difference is that, like I said earlier, Master Okawa is the grand savior named El Cantare, right? So, and El Cantare is the creator of this whole universe. So you're learning the teachings or the principles of how life works from the one who made it. So it's the answer, you know? And that's, I think, what makes a huge difference in the teachings of happy science.
And you also mentioned that happy science is one of the newer religions, but also the oldest one too, because yes. it encompasses all teachings, because there's one source behind it all. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, that answers the question of why is there religious conflict? There shouldn't be.
Yes.
You know, mm-hmm. if people just can understand this simple truth, mm-hmm. I think that the world would be a better place.
Right. I mean, and what makes it so complicated is that we're living in a very academic world now, so people are much smarter than thousands of years ago. Therefore, that has a lot of benefits in society, right? But the sad part is that we lose the sight of the simplicity.
Right.
And, you know, it's easy to say that all religions come from the same source. When I was in LA, there was always that, you know, sign that said coexist mm-hmm. with all of the kind of like the symbols of different religions, putting it together and kind of making the symbols of the letters coexist. Mm-hmm. It's easy to say, right? But it's hard to believe because our minds have become much more complicated and much more academic. And hence, that's what I like Master Okawa's teachings in Happy Science. He explains why, for an example, in Christianity, there's a lot of different gods in the Old Testament, right? Or different saviors or prophets. Mm-hmm. And he explains the differences and the reasons why behind all these different written teachings in the scriptures, and also he connects it to Buddhism and Islam and all Judaism, all Taoism, all world religions in a very simple but rational way.
Right.
So it's very compatible to this modern society.
Yes, yes. And I, you know, a lot of times we have new members or existing mm-hmm. members, of course, but they all say that, you know, they might have come from a different faith background, mm-hmm. but Happy Science answers all their questions, yes. which is so amazing, because mm-hmm. you know, we're different people have different backgrounds, but they're always searching for the truth.
Yes.
And I know it's the same for you as it is for me, but we all have found this comfort and yeah. like this conviction that there's always an answer to everything.
Yes.
You know, mm-hmm. and it's literally the place that we could find that. Mm-hmm. So there's mm-hmm. you know, there's that, which is kind of priceless. So
yep.
yeah. So I wanted to move on and mm-hmm. ask, you know, I'm sure people are like, what is it like to be a member of Happy Science?
Good question. Should I answer that first?
Sure.
What is it like to be a member? The greatest way to live. I mean, like you answered, you talked about this earlier, but you have answers to any kind of questions that comes out in your life. Mm-hmm. And when I say any kind of question, I mean any kind of question. Like when it comes to your individual stuff, individual life, you find answers to the reasons why you're suffering, and you find the solutions to it, and you gain like this lifelong confidence and positivity and comfort. So being a member is like you're living with the textbook that came directly from God. So you're never lost. It's like, you know, using an example of setting sail into the sea, living life is like, you know, you're setting sail into the seas. You mm-hmm. never know which way is going. You can see there could be storms and there could be, you know, all these different problems. But with being a Happy Science member, it's like you're given a compass that always points north. So you always know which direction that you have to go.
That's so true.
Isn't that powerful?
Yeah. No, it really is, because, you know, none of us are perfect, and all of us are always going to still be under training mm-hmm. because life is a training ground.
Mm-hmm.
But I also feel that the difference of me being a member and not, you know, being a member, I guess, mm-hmm. is the fact that at least we know how to get out of slumps, out of negativities, and we don't go in circles with our problems, because having the spiritual truth as wisdom, mm-hmm. as our knowledge, we can really do like auto therapy. You know, we don't need to go out and get therapy. Of course, we talk to each other and consult each other mm-hmm. and, you know, give each other advice. Of course, we're here mm-hmm. for that. But we also become more resilient, and
yes.
we are researching our mm-hmm. problems to figure out why, how, and how to become happier,
mm-hmm.
you know, why this happens. So it's really amazing that we can now be in control of our happiness and unhappiness mm-hmm. and decide not to be unhappy anymore.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, the bounce back from negativities is a lot bouncier.
That's true.
Say. You bounce way higher or quicker. Of course, there are down days, but you just bounce back quicker. So I feel these teachings, as you said, is a compass, is a GPS to our ultimate happiness.
And like, just, you know, being a member, you're going to be surrounded by people who are always seeking for higher enlightenment and who wants to, who feels a purpose in their life that's more than just bringing bread to your household, you know?
Yeah.
It's very high aspired, amazing people come to this Happy Science from different backgrounds. You can cherish diversity in a religion. Now, usually a lot of people think that that's not possible. Because, you know, if you're in one religion, you have that one tendency towards that direction. So, I mean, again, being the Sangha, which is the group of the membership of Happy Science, you can cherish the diversity of members, but all looking towards the direction of God and spreading love, right? And I don't think you can feel that in other religions, for sure, because all religions have the same tendency when you're in it. But Happy Science, because we believe that everything comes from the same source, we're allowed to cherish this diversity. Yeah. We have a lot of freedom in what to believe in. Right. Of course, not the negative side, but like we see the good in every aspect, and that's why the Sangha, or this Happy Science, being a part of the Happy Science member, is so great. You don't feel alone.
Right, and I've heard so many times, so many people, even myself, say, I have the best conversations at Happy Science. I can't talk about this stuff anywhere else. You know, so it's such a like a great place, a safe haven or an oasis or just a wonderful place where like-minded people gather and really kind of bounce back each other's divine nature.
Oh, yes.
You know, these kind of divine conversations happen all the time at Happy Science. So to finish up, we're going to answer a question that some of you might have, which is how to become a part of Happy Science, right? So there are two different kinds of systems or styles. One is the student membership, right? So in the student membership, you get this book, sutra, prayer book. It's called The Dharma of the Right Mind. And it has our basic three sutras or three prayers. One is the Dharma of the Right Mind, one is prayer to the Lord, and one is prayer to guardian and guiding spirits. So if you think, I want to learn more about Happy Science, I want to try this out, and I want to see how this goes and kind of start your faithful lifestyle or start to receive more light, then you become a student member. And whenever you're ready, or if you're willing to just dive right in, we have a devotee type of membership where you receive all five sutra books. This is the whole set. In the student membership, you get the first sutra, but there are seven. And then the prayer book one, prayer book two, prayer for the development of our temple, and prayer to El Cantare. So this is a complete set of becoming a devotee. And what you do normally is you come to the temple and you receive these books and you're given a very quick little ceremony to become a member and a devotee and a believer of El Cantare and the Fellowship of Happy Science, be a part of our Sangha. So those are the two different styles, and everyone's more than welcome, super wide open doors. And to finish up, maybe Yushi, you can give us a grand explanation on why Happy Science.
Why Happy Science? Yeah. Why not? I know it's, because I'm in it, I can already say why not. But it's just seriously the best way to, you know, optimize your life. You know the mission of your life. You have great friends, great teachings, and a wonderful master. And you can only feel that life is getting better and happier. And it gives you this great sense of mission. And like, I'm telling you, the reason why I have this passion welling up from the bottom of my heart is because you become so much happier and you're not gonna regret it. Actually, you're gonna regret it in the afterlife if you don't grasp this chance. So I hope that a lot of people can join us, and I'm not saying this for ourselves. Of course, it'll make us more happier, but literally, Happy Science is not just a religious institute. It's a whole conglomerate of how to spread happiness to this world. Mm-hmm. And each and every one of the members are nothing required, right? You explained to us the student membership and devotee membership. Is there like a requirement? Is there a commitment? Not really. The only thing that we ask you is to aspire to become a better person and truly manifest your mission as a child of God. And with that mind, living every day with that mindset, you'll see a huge change. So the doors are open to all. As Mariko said earlier, even if you have a different faith, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. There's a lot of Christian priests who are Happy Science devotees, Buddhist monks who are Happy Science devotees. So it really doesn't matter. We're all children of Alcantara. So I'm waiting for all of you to come and visit us.
Great. So thank you so much to all of you who are watching, to Yushi, and from all of us here at Happy Science and from Happy Science New York, we welcome you with open arms and we hope to see you soon. And also thank you for watching. Please subscribe, and we should be putting out a new video every 2 weeks, I think. We'll see what happens.
Hopefully.
hopefully down to once a week eventually. But thank you for watching, and
thank
see you next time.